This is Avi Fertig, director of Musser for the Musser Institute. In 1 week from today, Rosh Chodesh Elul, a month before the Jewish New Year of Rosh Hashanah, we begin our annual Elul program, which runs from Rosh Chodesh Elul, September 1st, until Yom Kippur, October 8th. In Musser tradition, this is a period of intense personal soul searching, of cheshbon hanefesh, accounting of the soul, as we prepare for a meaningful engagement with the high holidays. The Torah refers to the different months not by specific names, but as the first or second month after our miraculous exodus from Egypt. Nachmanides, Ramban, explains that the months were called in this way to remind us to be grateful to God for the miracles of Egypt. About 2,400 years ago, during the Babylonian exile, Jewish communities began using the names we know today, which are all ancient Babylonian words. Ramban explains that the change was instituted to recall the new divine redemption which the Jews experienced from Babel, or Babylonia. And so, for example, the month of Tevet means, in ancient Babylonian, the month where rain comes. Tishrei means the month of beginning. What does Elul mean, and what does the month of Elul signify? We turn to my Bar Mitzvah Parsha, Shelach, the story of the spies. We're all familiar with the story of the spies. The Jews went to Moses and said, we're about to enter the Holy Land, and we need to search it, we need to spy it out before we go in. And on the words Vayasuru, or Vayaturu et Eretz Kenan, which means to spy, the Targum translates as Ve'alelum, to spy or to search out. Ve'alelum is the word Elul. There's actually sources that indicate, although I think it might just be someone trying to give a good bar mitzvah speech, that you can find your essence in your bar mitzvah parsha. I have always been a searcher, a seeker, so maybe there's some truth to that. Elul is therefore the month of searching and seeking. However, we know that Elul focuses on teshuva, return. Are we focusing on the past, or are we searching for our future? Of course, the answer is we do both. We look to the past so that we can chart our future. The essence of Elul is searching our soul, looking at our past year to see where we went wrong so that we can do better in the future. Our focus is the coming year. How can we do better? Rabbi Chaim Friedlander, who passed away in 1986, he was the spiritual advisor of the Panovich Yeshiva in Bnei Brak, likened the month of Elul to the inventory that a shopkeeper does in order to know how to stock the shelves for the coming year. He explains further that the judgment that we have on Rosh Hashanah, that God judges us, is not to punish us for our past mistakes, nor to reward us for the positive things that we might have done. That comes only after death. The entire focus is whether or not you are a person who God wants in the world. Are you a person that God wants? Are you contributing to make this world a better place? Do your words and your deeds reflect the sort of person God wants in the world? How can I stock my shelves and prepare for the coming year? In Elul, we ask, what is my life's purpose, and how can I better achieve it? Our program this year is called Soul Searching. And to help you with your searching, we will be guided by six incredible Musser teachers. In the first 2 weeks, we will explore the general themes of teshuva, repentance, or to return, and cheshbon hanefesh, accounting of the soul, which are the primary foci of Elul from a Musser perspective. We will then explore the specific topics like building new habits, breaking old ones, experiencing God's presence in our lives, Kabbalot, New Year's resolutions, Selicha. The final week will be forgiving others, and asking for forgiveness. Each week will feature a podcast where I will be in conversation with a different Mussar teacher who will guide us for the week. These weekly podcasts will be followed by daily lessons on the week's theme to help support your learning and practice. Each day of our program will be sponsored by someone from our community in memory or in honor of a loved one or anyone who had significant influence in their life. Yes, that's a picture of my mother and me at my bar mitzvah, which hangs in my living room, in my dining room actually. And yes, I'm standing on something because she was 5'8" and I was 5'3". If you would like to support our work in this way by sponsoring a day of our ELO program, please be in touch with Michelle Jackman at mmjinc@aol.com. This year, we will also be offering our cherished Chaverim a special ELO intensive, which will allow for an even deeper dive into the themes of ELO. If you haven't already joined us, I urge you to join our growing Chaverim community. Please see the details on our website. Join me, join us, as together we will search our souls and come to experience a truly meaningful Elul and high holidays. Thank you for being together with me on this journey.